Hi, my name's Mary. I'm going to lead you through some yoga poses, followed by some gong sound therapy. Props for tonight include a couple of blocks, strap, a blanket, yoga mat, and a bolster. This is the Venus gong, and this is the planetary year gong. This one is resonating with the third eye chakra, and this one with the crown chakra. So with the yoga poses and the gong sound therapy, we'll be relaxing and balancing all of the seven chakras and doing some deep breathing to detoxify the body and to calm the body and to let the parasympathetic nervous system, the rest and relax and rejuvenate, healing part of our bodies, turn on and kick in and work their magic for overall health and well-being. So thanks for being here. We're going to get started on our backs. You can rest your head on top of the blanket to give a little natural tuck of the chin. So the blanket is folded just so there's about this much of the blanket still exposed, still unfolded. It's about an eighth fold. The head here. I will start with both soles of the feet on the mat, knees up, hands flat on the ground. We'll just start with breathing in unison. So right now, empty all the air out of your lungs. And we'll inhale together. Hold a little bit at the top, and slow exhale out the mouth. We'll breathe in through the nose and out through the mouth. And inhale. Hold. And exhale slowly. With every breath, it gets a little longer. Deeper, pushing more, exhale out, slow inhale, belly rises first, lungs rise second, hold at the top, and slowly release. Pull your left knee into the chest, right leg extends. Both feet are flexed, toes pointing up, heels out, heels pressing forward. You can pull your knee in as much as you'd like on a scale of 1 to 10. Leave it at about a 3. And we'll hold here for about a minute, and a half. Continue with the long, slow breathing. Chin is tucked. Inhale through the nose. And exhale through the mouth. Or through the nose. You might start to feel some sensations in the body. Just become aware of those areas and any thoughts or emotions that may arise. Just let them arise and pass by like clouds in the sky. Always returning to the breath. And a good place to always start is with the exhale. Let it out. And we do three more breaths right here. Pose might feel a little intense now, and just breathe through that. Inhales and exhales. Last breath. And then take your left knee over your right side. Just slowly rest it on the floor. And your left arm comes out in a T. Look, glancing over towards your left hand, palm is up. Right leg is elongated and relaxed. Laying out as the left knee tips over my right knee. Right foot is on the floor, but my left knee is still off the floor. So see how far is, again, like between 1 and 10, where are you at 3? We're going to hold that. Both arms can come out into a T. Trying to think about both shoulders coming down onto the mat. And just melt in. Sink your heart into the mat as your hip opens up further and further. You twist, open further and further. Continuing with the long, slow, deep breathing that starts with your belly, rising on the inhale, filling the big belly space and filling the lungs, and then releasing. Few more breaths here. Neck is easy and relaxed. Eyes are relaxed. Jaw is relaxed. As you melt further and further into the floor. Inhale, take your right hand and lift your left leg up with assistance, and slowly reach it out to meet the other leg. roll with about a 3 out of 10 force and find yourself in a comfortable pose and start by focusing on the breath to get into the pose and to relax into the pose. With yin yoga, we hold poses for longer periods of time to target the areas of the body which, when we're just walking around and using our bones and muscles, the parts of our bodies that are the connective tissues and the joints and the ligaments and the fascia are only targeted when you really hold these poses while your muscles are turned off. So right now, our glute is turned off, hamstring off, quad off. Everything is turned off, and we're using gravity, and we're using our arms, and our minds, and we're holding with the feet. We're targeting the areas in our legs that are normally turned off when everything else is fired on. So we're cleaning and clearing the energy lines. We're lubricating and we're strengthening and lengthening the fascia, joints, and tissues. And we're connecting breath with movement, mind with body. And slowing our pace down. Our shoulders are relaxed and down the back. Chin is tucked. Body is relaxed. And you may feel some sensations in that bent leg, around the psoas, hip flexor area. And that's right where there are major connective tissues in the hips and pelvic region that help us get up, walk around, sit down, do squats, jump around, do anything we need to do all day long. And here we squeeze, and we love, and we say thank you. And we're detoxing at the same time. And we're digesting, and we're releasing any kind of little type of baggage picked up throughout the day, yesterday, last week. When you were 5, you still think about that all the time. That we store in the hips. So if any kind of emotions or memories or thoughts come up, like I said, just let them pass by like clouds in the sky. You can shake your head no, your neck is easy and relaxed. And with your left hand, take your knee and tip it over to the left, right arm out into a T. Foot can come down, maybe knee comes down, maybe not. Both arms in T. And find your ease into the pose. Eyes and head, gazes over the right hand, palms facing up. leg is relaxed, kind of splayed open. Both shoulders are down on the mat, but don't force it. Just let your torso open up. Here, twist in the upper thoracic spine. Twist even further. Let your hips twist open even more as your right knee comes farther towards the mat and your right shoulder opens up even more. And then breathe. Both feet flat on the mat, knees up, knee position, feet as wide as the mat width apart, and windshield wiper your knees to one side, knees up, and twist on over to the other side. Knees up. And turn over onto all fours. And we'll go knees apart, feet together, and rest back into child's pose. And here, we'll hold child's pose for about 5 minutes. If it becomes too much, you can put a block. You can put a block in between your legs. And it takes some of the weight off. So again, find your three, and we're going to stay here for a few minutes while I open up the gong. Let's take one breath together right here and empty out all the air from your lungs. And slowly inhale. From here, come on out into Cobra Pose with both arms in a 90-degree angle, legs straight behind you, curving your back, curving the lower back. That's supported with the forearms pressing up from the mat. Heart lifts forward. Eyes can be gently closed or a little bit open. Gentle gaze. Neck is relaxed. Shoulders stay down and back from the ears. As you exhale, try to open the spine and open the heart just a little further. Inhale fills the belly and the belly lifts. Lifts heart and chest rises. On the inhale, slow exhale. Flow to this like a small wave. Just be still in the body and flow with the breath. Hips and pelvis sink and melt further into the mat. Neck is easy, you can even nod your head, yes, to make sure. Shake your head no, nice and slow. Shake your head, just keep it nice and easy and relaxed. We're targeting the middle of the thoracic spine and the lower back. And also a little bit of the shoulders will start to feel burned. And just breathe into it. Three more breaths right here. before coming all the way down, lift yourself just a little bit further up and thread your right hand under your shoulder and your left hand out the other direction. And keep wiggling and stretching with your fingertips out and out until your arms are stretched out. And then head just rest, neck rest on over top of the shoulders for shoelace pose. Breathing deeply here. It should be a little harder, a little constricted, but that's okay. You can just breathe through that and with nice, slow, easy breathing. Slowly lift your head up a little bit. I'm just going to switch arms. So left arm threads under and right arm is on top. And then inch out, and neck and head just rest easy over top. Just get a little balance in the shoulder stretch. Slowly lift your head up and come up to the elbows. And turn over onto your backs. Grab a block. And we'll get into restorative bridge pose. Both feet flat on the floor, knees up. Feet should be pretty close to the butt. You can kind of inch them back a little bit. Shoulder width apart. You can also scoot your butt closer to them. There should just be a few inches in between your feet and your butt. Shoulder stay on the ground and slowly lift up and slide that block right under. On your sit or the base of your spine. So your pelvis is fully supported on top of the block. You can set it up to the next height by just scooching it up from there. Shoulders come down and back. Make sure your knees and ankles are aligned straight. From your ankles to your knees to your hips and shoulders are all on the same track, like on a train track, two sides of your train track. Palms can be up, facing up, or facing down, whichever you feel like doing today. When they're facing up, you're more receptive to receiving energies and to receive what you need to become into balance. And when you feel like placing them down, you're maybe more revved up and you need to give a little bit back to get into balance, to give energies. If you're too ramped up, stressed out, panicky, anxiety, and open up. If you feel more ready to receive energies that may be depleted, and to fill that back up, you feel tired, and you feel lazy, and you feel lonely or sad, and you could use some filling of your cup and place your hands up. Back of the head is kind of firmly in contact with the mat. You can focus your point there. Now breathe. If your knees start to fall apart, be mindful of that and keep knees tracking above ankles and in line with the hips. If you need to come down a level on your block, you can do so. Again, you want to be between a 3 and a 10. So always keep that in mind with Yin style yoga. We never want to push ourselves too hard. What we aim to do is target different areas of the body and different energy lines and sensitive areas or particularly overworked areas, and to give a little TLC in the form of posture, breath, twisting, lengthening, squeezing. All of it helps to clear and clean our bodies from the attack. With the gong sound therapy, the sounds hit you at a cellular level, right on top of the skin level too, but they travel as sound vibrations through your body's water and liquid mass to touch and reach every nook and cranny of the body for healing and rising. Lift all 10 toes off the mat and make sure they're just relaxed. A couple more breaths right here. If it's too much, you can lower down already. Nice and slow. Let's take one breath together and exhale. Slow in here. And exhale. Let it go. Gently use your feet to pick yourself up and remove that block and slowly lower down. Feet as wide as the mat, do a couple windshield wipers, block and reset side. And then right leg stays planted and left leg comes over for figure four. Flexed feet and bring your right knee into your chest. And use your two hands behind your hamstrings and gravity to pull and open up your hip. On the right, and stay at about a 3 out of 10. Chin tucks. You can actually bring the blanket back in for the chin tuck. Automatic chin tuck, what you like. We'll roll that blanket behind your head. And as we slip into figure four on this side, and then we'll hold for a while and switch over to the other side. I'm going to get back up and play a little bit more of the gongs. We have one more move after this before final resting pose in Shavasana. Now I'll just settle in, shoulders down and back, breath long, right, left foot flexed, make sure your knee stays intact. And if you need to back out, just lower your leg down and keep your top leg opened up for a more passive hip opener. For more active, bring it on back. And ease into it. I will tell you when to switch. Stay put for now. Thank you. just a couple breaths and we'll come meet up and sitting. Take your time. Excuse me. And kind of keep your eyes a little closed, a little soft gaze. Come back into easy pose with the hands in front of our hearts. We'll take an inhale together. And exhale. And on this next breath, we'll